I'll quickly introduce the guys before I go on it. Up here in the top right, we have our blue Protoss player from Team TSL, or Team SCV Life. He is Inori, winning game number one against this man down here, thanks to a nice two base Blinkstalker all-in with plus two. He is hailing from Startale. He is our Red Zerg. He is Kingkong. And there you go. Yes, this is the final for you guys. Game number one has already been won by TSL. I believe this is the best of three as well, so Inori needs to win this. And he gets first place seeds. And as well, actually, I think, guys, just stay around and tune in. I will have the brackets, actually, for tomorrow's game. I will show them to you after this. I believe I have, secretly between you and me, I've already done them. So, but I will fit in who qualifies and stuff here. So, stick around if you want to see the brackets. I'm sure Nirvana will post them anyway, so not too much anyway. But yeah, back on the whole Twitch thing. Twitch, you know that Own3D uses IRC as their chat, like, you know, just plain old. But Twitch actually uses IRC as well. The only thing is they've developed their chat system that makes it look prettier, but they're still using IRC. So, all in all, it's the same kind of thing altogether. Yeah, that's the gist of it. Apparently, the infrastructure for owned is better than Twitch. I don't know. I mean, it'll come down to testing. I mean, all in all, it doesn't really matter. The only thing is I'll be partnered on Twitch, or well, assuming I get partnered. So the only thing that's positive there is that Twitch will have the quality change option, as I'm stuttering my sentence. I cannot get these words out today. The quality change option, whereas owned 3D will not, but hopefully I can be like, your owned 3D. I'm partnered on Twitch. Swing it my way, Brohan. Love Wednesday. Well, we'll see anyway. I'm playing around with it. We'll see how he goes. A lot of people are switching to owned, and I wonder why. So, it's tweaked my curiosity. But here we go, the Overlord here from Saltale King Kong already on the way. We have a Forge Fast Expand. It looks like we have a Nexus first coming out here for Inori, following it up with the Forge. The Overlord is in a very nice position. It can still be spotted. It needs to just notch over a little bit. It'll be fine. King Kong going for the third base here, as it has been blocked. Well, there was a pylon. I believe it did get cancelled, but the probe here is darting back and forth. Link's going to stream out, and they're just, well, I mean, that probe doesn't even care. Will that probe survive? Oh, one Link's going to chase it. Fair enough. The Overlord doesn't even care. He's like, listen, mate, I know you told me to get on the ledge, but I don't care, man. I'm sitting here. I am sitting here. And there we go. Ling's going to start streaming across the way. Cannon's actually really slowed, actually, but I believe this is a complete wall, and so the Ling's shouldn't do too much damage. They're going to start nibbling away at the pylon. The cannon will finish in about 15 seconds, but the pylon might fall. Oh, my God. There's only two pylons here. That pylon will fall. The cannon will not get up. Oh, my God. The Gateway is now under siege. The cannon completes and the pylon completes as well. So, there you have it. And the Lings are just darting back and forth. King Kong doing what he can. We'll lose the Ling though. Gets to cancel. The Lings dart in. Oh, tried to get in there. And there you have it. Third base slash second base coming down for King Kong. Working on his way here. The Queens working their way in. Again, if you are just joining us, this is the on the North American server where the patch updates has been released. That means that Overlord speeds, as I've shown plenty of times today. Look at him go! Look at him go! What a nuts, man. Look at this guy. Down, 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 down. Oh, man. I should get some of these sound files just on cue, ready to go. Working the way across. But yeah, so like I said, the Overlords do have the speed. We have the Queens with the plus 5 range attack. So we'll have to see how it's going to help out here. But here's the Chrono Boost going on the way. He does not have vision of that Overlord. It has been repositioned in a nice position there. And what do we got here? For the Forge not upgrading anything, we've got the Summoning Core doing Warpgate Research. This probe, will it get out? Oh, it does manage to sneak out, but King Kong's on it, ready to go. That probe is will get sniped. Doesn't already know the third. He knows about this base. Doesn't know about this base, though. But, I mean, you can assume. Usually when a Zerg goes and takes this base, it generally means he's going three base. I mean, if you want to sit on two base with just this one, it's kind of dumb, but I don't know. And always going to come up here. He sees the creep, so he's like, okay, well, that's pretty much a telltale sign. Going to use the probe now to go into the natural, which is a good choice, I feel. The probe will get in. The Lings will not be able to snipe it. He sees the creep there and goes, okay, that's fair enough. I mean, I understand the creep here, because it's... I mean, there's... Oh, I guess you could go... No, you can't go creep Jimmy here into there, can you? So, I mean, to creep all of this area, it's really long. So, I mean, you see the creep here, you can just go, okay, fair enough. But to see the creep here, I mean, that's kind of risky, because it's not that hard to get a creep Jimmy to here. Regardless, we do have a bit of pressure here at the third. The queen, look at the queen rage, man. The queen can kite against zealots. Can actually efficiently kite against zealots. 0.156. What's 156 plus 0.9? Is that 2.4? Zealots are 2.2. Yeah, queens actually move faster than zealots on creep. I'm thinking they always did, but it's easier to micro to kite. But anyway, we have four gases here in grand total. Look at this speed overlord. Look at him go. This overlord, man. It knows what it wants. It will fall, it will fall, however. What did King Kong see? Let's quickly grab one of his units. He has, in fact, spotted extra gates getting thrown down. Didn't, unfortunately, see the Stargate, though. But he wants to try and see what's going on. We have a Roach Warrant and an Evolution Chamber coming down, as well as the Lair kicking off here for Startale's King Kong. We've got four gas in total. No spores being thrown down just yet. Getting spines for defense, a good choice as well. And looks like this could be all she wrote for the time being. Pretty good creep spread here from King Kong. I like this. Like it a lot. Lair completes. Do we have roach speed? Yes, we do. Push the evolution chambers is a bit slow, but that's alright. There it goes. Will we see plus one? It's going for the armor first. I like it. I like the choice of going armor first against a Protoss. Protosses generally all, well, more often than not, will like to go for the attack upgrade straight off, so obviously they go for that quick plus one for the zealot timing, which we're not seeing, but then they follow it up with plus two and eventually plus three before they, you know, focus on armor upgrades, of course, assuming they don't have two forges on the field. So I like the idea of going armor first here for King Kong. It's basically nullifying that attack, which is a good choice there. And as I just showed you guys on stream, King Kong did see the Phoenix. The Phoenix is going to start rolling the way across. Overlords will start getting shot at. The Queen will start throwing things at it. We'll get picked up, though. The Overlords on a fast retreat. Look at them go! Oh, my God. Never going to get over that. Spore Coil does finish, though. Do we have a Spore in the natural? Let's take a quick look. Yes, there is already a Spore. Macro Hatch going down, as well as another Spore. Phoenix is going to try, and they will snipe at one Overlord for free. Will they dart into the main? There is Spores already up. So King Kong's pretty well defended against this. Oh, Phoenix is... Bit sloppy play there from TSLInori, but does pick it up. One drone does get sniped instantly. I'm trying to follow these Phoenixes as best as I can. But I'll just do it on the old auto cam here. That's going to be all she wrote. Third base coming down now for Inori. King Kong spots it with a nice Link Scout and sees double cannon, so he knows what he's up against. So we're having a quite heavy macro game. TSLInori is going for the complete wall in, but leaves this gap here. So can leave himself vulnerable to a destructible rock counterattack. But we have a robotics facility now kicking off here. The Stargate is completely inactive now. Take a look at the supplies. 63 to 65 workers in favor of Inori now. Army supply is 28 to 40 in favor of Inori. So the overall food is in favor of Startale King Kong, actually. 20 drones up. I guess that makes sense. Now getting a fourth base. I mean, you can basically do this. Phoenix cannot shoot the ground, so you can just expand as much as you want. We'll just see if he will even throw and expand there. I mean, like I said, these Phoenixes can't do anything about it. Clear out the Zelnagas, which is good. A few links running around here. Excuse my yawn. And does see that. Oh, well, he already knew that. That was up, so I don't know why he sacrificed a few more links. Not too sure. But Startale now has his fourth base up, King Kong, that is, ready to macro and punch out a whole ton of units. He's got Burrow just complete. We've got plus two melee. We've got plus two ground carapace. Plus one melee, sorry. Do we have plus one missiles? No, we do not. We have six infestors. Pathogen glands just finished up. More and more roaches kicking off. On the other hand, look at the speed overseer go. Corrupted a changeling, checking things out. Sees the army of his opponent. And just going to sit there at the moment. Checks his upgrades as well. Sees he's on plus one. Goes, okay, fair enough. I'm cool with that. An immortal joins the field. Do we have a robotics bay? We do not. Ooh, Startale's King Kong spots the Twilight Council researching Blink. Can perhaps use it as a timing, perhaps. Fourth base is complete here for King Kong, working on it. Just making a whole ton of roaches. The Phoenix is under here. They do see the infestors, though. Which is, well, I guess that's good for Inori. Bad for King Kong, but still. Changeling here for King Kong. Ooh! Overseer will fall. There she goes. And I mean, we're just macroing up at the moment. Drones are going to make their way down here towards the fourth. Probably wanted to make sure the Spore Crawler is completed before transferring to drones. Good choice there. Playing safe. Using the links to hold the Zelnaga. Observers here for King Kong sees everything. Even sees a fourth base. Phoenix is going to dart their way around, perhaps try and see if they can sneak some free kills at this fourth, but again, like I just showed, already a spore crawler here, and King Kong even favoring sending his drones on the left. I don't know if that was on purpose or not, but that's pretty cool. Goes for the lift up, picks up a drone, and gets on out of there. Misses the fungal, unfortunately, King Kong, but now throwing down a whole ton of spires. Looks like he wants to transition into the Greater Spire Broodlord mix. There's the Spire, there's the Greater Spire, or the Hive, sorry, excuse me. And unfortunately it's a bit delayed, but I mean, can he squeeze out a plus one attack? What's plus one? 160, 100, so it doesn't look like he will be able to. So he's just going to have to wait. We've got plus two ground carapace on the way, plus two melee as well. There's one infestor. Might be able to snag a bunch of phoenixes. Ling's coming around for... Oh, he survives with the Ling. Nice. Pretty nice there. That is cool. That I did not know. You could actually lift up borrowed units. That is actually pretty smexy. But what will he have come down here for King Kong? Just macroing up on infestors, getting these roaches up. Needs to start sacrificing units soon, I feel. He is at cap population. That hive is about 30 seconds away. Still has to wait for the Greater Spire Morph, which is 100 seconds as well. So still quite a while for Broodlords to hit the field. Already preemptively making a few Corruptors as well. He's probably going to use it with the attack to take out the Colossus and the Void Ray that's now actually in the field here. But it looks like here we go. Inori's going to go for the attack. King Kong has to be playing very defensive. Spinecrawler has already been instantly dumped down, making up supply for that transition. We have Baneling Nest coming out here for King Kong. Interesting choice here. 13 Spinecrawlers on the morph. Wow. Where are the rest of them? Oh, they're at the natural. Oh my god, this one infestor just chilling. But here we go. Link's going to dart across. Oh, that's going to be it. And we have a Warp Prison coming out now for Inori. Nice fungal there. Catches a few of the units. We'll lose the infestor, however. There it falls. But he is fighting on creep. Inori is getting a fourth base here, by the way. Mass cannons getting dumped down. He's going to push here into the fourth. Inori, yes, I can get rid of the UI, which is excellent. Colossus is going to start working away. The Corruptor is going to start doing damage to the Colossus. Massive fungal. Look at the Corruptors. The Colossus die instantaneously. Phoenix is getting picked up as well. Oh, sorry, they're picking up Infestors. Miss on the few of the force fields there, but still cleans up a lot of damage there. And King Kong is just basically making way for his Broodlords. He needs to buy time though. That Greater Spire is about 20 seconds away. The Corruptors is all he needs. He's got Infestors here ready to go. The Link comes around scouting it, but Inori is not giving out with the pressure. The Pilot is on the way. Where is that Warp Prism? Is it on the fields? Where is it? Why do I not see it? I can't see it. Is it not anywhere? Is that it? Oh, I don't know. Link counterattack though at the fourth. Plenty of cannons for defense though. These links aren't going to do too much damage. And now quick on the retreat there as Inori retreats as well to help defend this. Is that the Warp Prism? It's not the Warp Prism. Where's the Warp Prism? I can't find it. Whatever, man. He might have lost it. It is on the field. Oh, there it is. Okay. Hello. Link's darting back and forth trying to do what they can. They're going to come down here. Will they borrow? Or they're just going to take the back path around. All well and goody good there. It was the Warp Prism's making its way across the field. But we see some cheeky shenanigans. Looks like that's exactly what it's doing. It's queued up to warp in at the back of the main here. Does fly over a lot of units here from Startale's King Kong, so he knows what's going on. Can use the Speed Overlords to just butt rush. just to ram that Warp Prism. Reinforcements are retreating here from Startale's King Kong. He's actually retreating all of his units. Oh wow, look at all these Broodlords. Getting a base down here at the bottom right as well, but a single Zealot does manage to catch it. Three attack here coming out here for Inori on the upgrades. Here comes the Warp Prism though. Does fly straight over a Spore Crawler. Will he lose it? Oh, it's 27 health left on it. Pretty nice to have a few links. Don't know what they're doing. Probably just saving him. Can he attack the third? No, he cannot. Plenty of cannons. Can't attack the fourth either. Can attack the natural though. Another gateway coming out here for Inori. Feeling all well and good. What was that? What was that? Looks like it's a fleet beacon and more gateways. So Inori is going to transition to Mothership, which is basically what you need to do in this matchup, especially coming up against Broodlords. Broodlords are already on the field. Where are they? Here they are. Oh my god, look at the Broodlords. 12 Broodlords at a grand total. Do these Stalkers have Blink? They must. Yes, they do. These are plus 3 attack Stalkers, which can do a lot of damage. But these Broodlords are actually unupgraded. 1-1 Flyers is on the way out as well. Oh my god, all the drones are bunching up. The Colossus. Nice fungal on the Colossus, though. Taking a lot of damage from the Fungals. Got to chain the Fungals so the Colossus doesn't move. Phoenixes do get fungled as well. The Broodlords coming down here. Snipes those Colossus instantly. Very nice Fungals there. And oh my god. Inori is now on the full retreat. because my voice is starting to hurt. Banelings into the third. Oh my god! Well, see you later, probes. 87-56 is now the count. I mean, that was good. That was good. I approve of that message. I was like, oh, you can't really send links down. There's plenty of cannons, but why not make Banes? I guess that makes sense why we saw a Baneling nest. Double Spire down here now for Startale. Obviously, we saw it with the 1-1 working out. We have the Phoenixes making their way across down here in the bottom right. The hatchery did get denied here, as you see the remnants of the creep slowly dissipating. And they're on patrol at the moment. Inori now pushing away. He's back at Food Catch, but so is King Kong. Ready to roll. Look at all these Broodlords ready to go out. The Infestors coming out here. So we have Infestors, we got Broodlords, we got Corruptors. No links on the field too much, really, at the look of it. But we're going to have to wait for the time being. Stalkers are on the retreat for the now. Both players are just kind of scared to attack. Obviously, I think Inori might be waiting for that mothership. That's exactly what's going on. We had a double... Double warp prism, here they are. Double warp prism making their way across. Oh my god, blink! Onto the overlords, but they're speed overlords! Look at them get away! What up, son? You can't touch these! Stalkers are look, oh my god. That's broodlords. Oh my god, the overlords, these are so hilarious. I love overlords now. I'm gonna switch to Zerg just for the pure fact of having speed overlords. Oh man. Dark Shrine coming out now for Inori. That mothership is on the way. Oh my god, the double, oh, he didn't see him! He does, the Corruptors chase him down. Warp Prism goes for the warp in. Nice Fungal catches him here, and the double queen's gonna work away. See you later, Warp Prism. Base down here in the bottom right on the way as well. The patrolling Phoenix does spot what's going on. Here we go. The Stalkers are gonna push up here into the right. Gonna start clearing out the creep. We heard the mothership land. Whereabouts is she? The main, the natural, the third. Is that the third? There it is. Well, King Kong ready to push out. He can get a good flank onto this. He can totally segregate this army away from the mothership. The mothership's not even bothering to move. But here comes the attack though. Coming in from a flank. Do we have it? Oh my god, we have a base trade. We have a base trade situation, but it looks like Inori, though, cutting quite out of position. He's going to have to retreat. That's his army. I'm not liking the look of his army here against King Kong's mass broodlords here. And it looks like we are, in fact, going to have a base trade situation. A whole ton of drains here currently idle. Not really minding. They have been pulled from that previous attack. The Spine Claws aiding with the defense. The fourth here from Inori will fall. Mass broodlords coming out here. Banelings are going to roll their way. They are speed banes. And then it looks like they will get cleaned up pretty convincingly there. The fourth base here for King Kong is going to get sniped. He's losing overlords even though they're speed. Nerf speed. Mass changelings going to charge their way in, ready to go. And Broodlords going to slowly punch their way through. And this is actually looking... this is hard to tell who's going to win this. Inori's going to push into it. It's going to take bases. He definitely has the army to really snipe out these bases. But King Kong has a whole ton of resources banked up. He is supply block though, unfortunately. We've got plus 2 armor, we'll kick off, the probes will fall. Inori is trying to refeat, these two colossus aren't really going to help at all. Changeling come in and sees what's going on. This is a mass warping of stalkers and double colossus. Inori took out the fourth base, took out the third base, tanks out the, excuse me. But the third base here for Startale is already underway, he needs to recap. He has actually made a whole ton of units and looks like we didn't have a base trade. It's kind of a mini base trade, I guess. There's the mothership man here for Inori. The 100 energy is complete. Can Vortex and Mass Recall, but Vortex is probably the one he's looking for. Oh my sweet lord, 20 Broodlords is the official count here from the unit counting station. And no Archons though, so I mean, the Archon Toilet isn't really going to be that effective. Because obviously there's no Archons. You know, but... I mean, they can basically nullify the Broodlords for the entire fight. Inori's going to go for it though. The Broodlords are horrendously stacked up. King Kong though, not going to pressure it, neither does Inori. Bit risky to do so. Another Broodlord is on the way, so that will make 21. The Warp Prison loads up here. Here we go. 4 Zealots get warped into the main. A whole ton more Zealots. DTs to accommodate this force as well. Gonna go straight for the Spire by the looks of it. No, the Evolution Chamber is going for the Greater Spire. The Greater Spire will no doubt fall. And that's gonna be it for Broodlords. Meanwhile, engagement in the middle. King Kong's too busy microing in the middle. Oh my god. So much action coming out. Vortex goes down, catches a few of the Broodlords. The Broodlords doing a whole ton of damage, but looks like all the units have fallen. Blink goes underneath those Broodlords. The Broodlords will fall. The Infestors trying to do what they can. The Greater Spire does fall. The Roach Warren as well. The DT's doing a lot of damage. These plus 3 DT's doing 60 damage per swipe. And it looks like this might be it. Inori's gonna blink up into here, trying to take off the rest of the Broodlords. The Broodlords will fall. The mass Colossus come out of here to help. We've got more and more Colossus joining the field here. These this nice little War Prison player has cleaned up the base here. All of the tech with Star Towers King Kong has been drastically reduced. Will fall here. The Broodlords are all getting sniped as well. Reinforcing Broodlords come down here from Star Towers King Kong, but at what cost? Nice Fungals though, doing a lot of damage here to the army. We have some Zealots coming out here, some Broodlords as well. Here comes the army here. They have cleaned up here. The Hive is taking seriously massive beatings here. And looks like that is going to be it. King Kong has lost his entire army. He's got nothing left, unfortunately. He's lost his main. A whole ton of leagues are going to come here and retreat. But he does have detection though with this Swarm Caller. But the Hive does fall. Spawning Core will fall as well. The attack on this base over here. Look at the Spine Callers. They're trying to get down, man. They're like, what? God, get down. Burrow, damn it. Burrow, damn you. But it looks like that's, all the leagues are going to come up here. They're going to get cleaned almost instantly thanks to the plus 3 Colossus. Perhaps they're doing some nice damage, but for the rest of it here, there's just quite a few of these Spine Calls unburrowed. DTs are just chilling here at the moment. But once this base falls, I think that might be the final nail in the coffin here from King Kong. Remaking the spawning pool. Got 3 drones. The Spine Crawlers will fall. And well, there you go. That gets cleaned up. We've got a whole ton of investors. DT's doing some damage. Nice Fungals to detect it. The DT, look at the queen go, man. He can just kite. Look at this. This is when you see a queen kite against the DT. Oh my god, that queen survives. Wow. Mass Infest is going to head the way of it, but that's going to be it. GG is called. And game number 2 and the series with it as well as the tournament goes to Team SCV Life Inori.